What you are looking at is the towering monolithic edifice of a geologic formation known as Pilot Rock. Located in Oregon, it rises nearly 170 meters or 557 feet above the surrounding landscape, allowing its numerous hexagonal columns to come into view. This feature was originally thought to represent the below-ground interior of an ancient stratovolcano, perhaps similar in size to Mount McLaughlin, with more than 20 million years of erosion having removed the mass of rock and placed above it. However, while this explanation is still certainly quite plausible, very shallow bodies of magma do not always reach the surface. Sometimes, magma simply intrudes into the crust in a volcanic belt or large zone of weakness, and since the vast majority of magmatic intrusions do not reach the surface and produce an eruption, regional volcanism leaves behind stray intrusive bodies. I prefer the latter explanation when discussing this beautiful geologic feature, as nearby there are several other similar features which once existed, but whose towering edifices were eroded long ago. Each of these intrusive igneous structures represent remnants of the now extinct Western Cascade Range. The Western Cascade Range represents the original, more limited birth of the now infamous mountain range, with it only stretching from the far northern end of California just a few miles west of the modern Mount Shasta through an area just east of Salem, Oregon. It was active between 35 and 17 million years ago and over time slowly expanded to the north and south, further expanding to the south once the San Andreas Fault formed 30 million years ago. So, as you look onto the edifice of Pilot Rock, picture a mountain range and volcanic chain that stood on average 500 meters or 1,640 feet higher than the current landscape. This mountain range had snow-capped peaks along with fresh cinder cones occasionally dotting the forested landscape. And 25.6 million years ago, when the Pilot Rock intrusion occurred, there may have been some young, unforested lava flows overlying the specific spot where the eventual intrusion would happen of a basaltic composition similar in appearance to those seen on the northern flank of the Newberry volcano today. Due to the ancient subduction of the Juan de Fuca tectonic plate beneath the North American plate, an intrusion of magma began progressing upwards through the continental crust. As a result, unusually viscous magma with a medium silica content began generating a swarm of earthquakes which got stronger and more significant over time. Several magnitude 3 and 4 range earthquakes struck along with hundreds of lesser events as the ground bulged upwards by a foot due to rising magma. And then, as days turned into weeks, the intrusion of magma stalled and ceased its upward motion, likely getting to within 3,000 feet of the surface, shallow enough that it may have even generated temporary overlying geothermal features. As the pillar-shaped intrusion cooled over the following several hundred to several thousand years, the colder material at the top of the intrusion due to the geothermal gradient cooled first. This caused the rock to contract, breaking into several pentagons and hexagons as these shapes represented the easiest way for the solid rock to break and accommodate the stress related to contraction. These polygon shapes then propagated downwards over time as the rest of the magma cooled, resulting in the creation of numerous beautiful pillars of andesite rock. Yes, that is correct. Despite having a dark black color typical of basalt, Pilot Rock is composed of andesite. This andesite just so happens to be unusually rich in a dark black mineral known as hornblende, which formed due to unusually abundant groundwater the intruding and cooling magma interacted with. Across the next 25 million years, more than 1,000 feet of overlying softer rock eroded away, with the harder rock of the intrusive mass being more resistant to erosion, eventually being exposed for all to see. During this time span, Pilot Rock was also tilted about 15 to 20 degrees to the east due to the uplift of the Siskiyou Mountains. Thanks for watching. As a final note, I would like to thank my new patron Logan Shomu for supporting this channel.